Hello. Today I want to show you a journal I've just finished. This one was created for the Tsunami Rose design team. And before showing it, I want to say a big thank you to Daisy for allowing me to join the team. I hope I'm not disappointing her and she likes what I created. For the month of June, we were supposed to create a journal using the Hummingbird kit. It is a beautiful kit with very soft and delicate colors and images, as you will see. And this is the journal. It is around 8x5. I used cardstock for the cover, went over it with some distress vintage photo, used metal corners to reinforce the corners. To decorate the cover, I used scrapbooking paper from my stash, a book page, a torn book page. This image was a freebie from internet. I stamped memories. This is some sari ribbon that came all the way from India, from Nicola. This is some gauze. Here we have a flower that I made using some fabric. Here is some gauze. In the center we have a jewelry piece and some more ribbon. On the spine I used two layers. First is a very delicate lace, and then we have this beautiful one that was sent to me by Jenny from Germany. And here just a safety pin, a pearl and a little bit of lace. And all around there is also some gauze. The back was left plain, just with some scrapbook paper. The closure are two eyelets, one on the front and one on the back, and I tied it with T-dyed seam binding. And let's see the inside. The inside cover, I also used some scrapbooking paper from my stash. This is some paper with stenciling, and I punched it with a border punch. And inside this pocket is a tag I created with the leftover paper from the cover. This is a beautiful envelope from the kit. All the papers are tea-dyed and distressed. Inside there is journaling paper. As you can see, the kit has beautiful and soft images and colors. Here on this page I have one of Patricia's envelopes. I decorated it with some tea-dyed bag and lace and one of my crochet flowers. Inside there are two journaling cards, things to do, and this one. Here on the back, a tag with "And the Story Begins," of course. And some journaling paper I had. Here is some printed dyed pattern I achieved with the grill. And journaling card I stamped. Here is a big tag I created, also with leftover paper from here. And I stamped the definition of cherish. And I want to thank you to Monique in Australia for sending me this stamp set. I love it. Thank you. And this is some flowers I punched. Here I stamped one of the hummingbird's favorite flowers. If you want to know anything about the stamps I used, just let me know in the comments. This is a library pocket I've made and then stamped a hummingbird, and inside there is a library pocket from Tsunami Rose and a simple tag with love word stamped. Here I used for a tuck just this die cut and stamped this sentence. I don't know if you can see. It's the simple things that make the magical moments we remember. This is a paper napkin. I decoupage here with a hummingbird, and here is an envelope I created. Just sewed around and used this one, has a template trace here, and decorated with a paper flower, distressed, and a fabric flower. Inside I created this card also with the same napkin with the corners stamped. And around here I just stamped stop, smile, breathe, life is beautiful. This is another stamped image, a hummingbird, just love this stamp. This is a pocket, a double pocket I created. This is also open here, and this is a telegram from the kit. And this is also a postcard from the kit. It's beautiful ephemera and very versatile. It can be used in any other journal with another theme. There. Another page from the kit. This is the ink bleeding because I always tea dyed after printing, and sometimes I like what the ink makes. And here we have one of those crafty Arena pockets. I just didn't glue it all the way, so I have 4 tuck spots and also a flip corner. Here one, I just left it open on the sides. A tag, dare to dream. And this one from some scrapbooking paper I had. Another postcard from the kit. And here another tag with the same stamp I showed before. Here some scrapbook, some journaling paper, sorry, from the kit. For extra journaling. And here this is a graphic 45 pocket I had in my stash, and it was perfect because it has an hummingbird image and it's double-sided, so I didn't glue it, just left it here. Another page from the kit. Another one of those sentences. A smile happens in a flash, but its memory can last a lifetime. Sorry. This is one of those folded papers from Paula Lemon. There, with journaling. And it's also has a tag spot. This is a tag where I sewed a book page corner to hold a little tag with love, and a stamp. Be happy, be bright, be you. Here is another stamped pocket I created, and inside it's a 3-page journaling place. I joined them with a bread and to hold the metal, to hide the metal, just glued here a heart paper punch. It's just plain paper, so it's kind of thin. There another image, another page from the kit, some more stamping, some more stenciling. Here one of the jelly bean pockets with a simple tag inside. This is just a paper flower cut I had. And this is another page, journaling page from the kit. Another page. This is a music paper page. This is a flower from a napkin. And there it has another telegram and another postcard. And here we have a flip corner. I just sewed it and then it hides here a little tuck spot where I included this stamped card. And I decorated it with some lace flowers. This is a parchment paper page. Another page from the kit. Here we have a double tuck spot, corner spot, a postcard, and here are two tags I had in my stash, both with hummingbirds, so they were perfect for here. And the corner is decorated with a fussy cut tsunami rose flowers, embellished with eyelash trim and gauze. This is a folded page with a tab and some stenciling here, and on the other side there are two journaling cards I also stamped there. This is one of the pages from the kit, things to do. This is some gauze and another paper cut I had. Another page from the kit. Here we have a smaller page with two corners, and inside is an image I found online. It's a freebie. And this is the center of the signature I sewed around to create these double pockets and stencil them, then made two little corners stamped, and inside they hold two journaling cards each, things to do, and this is a little tag I had. And here, things to remember, and another one of those, and another little tag. Each pocket here has a telegram from the kit, a different one, this one, and this one, and the other side is exactly like this one, and this is another freebie image. Here another tag, this one with the definition of believe. Another things to do list, and another one of those tags, and another one of those folded pages there. Here another double corner on the upper corner, and this one also has a postcard and two tags from my stash. Here is the other side of the music page. Another telegram there, and another postcard. And the same here, a journaling card. This one was embellished with a paper flower I made with book pages. Not sure if you can see. There, this is another one of the jelly bean pockets. A tsunami rose flower, a simple tag inside, and here another journaling page. More stenciling. This is a belly band with a freebie I found, and this belly band is like when I saw on a Paula Lemon's journal. It's just some folded paper for extra journaling space, and I am embellished with a paper punch here on the border, and a ticket and some gauze. Dare to Dream, another tuck spot. This is one of Yvonne's envelope pocket, and inside the Cherish definition. This was sewed at sewing machine. Another mini tag and another postcard. This was embellished with some lace and another crochet flower and another punched flower. Another jelly bean pocket. This one I stamped happiness, and inside a happiness definition. And here two more journaling cards I stamped. I love to stamp my ephemera. And this page is a tuck spot from, it's a pocket from a scrapbooking paper I had, embellished with some fabric and paper flowers. Inside just a stamped paper and another paper I have. More stenciling, another of those pockets, double pockets, with a postcard and another beautiful telegram. And this is the other side of that page, that is an envelope. Inside is exactly the same, and also stamped the same sentence at the bottom. Here some more paper napkin decoupage. This is another one of paper journaling paper folded. Inside two little tags and simple ones. Those I make with not a file folder, sorry. One of those cards. I'm sorry, I forgot. Another stamped pocket. This one with Live, Love and Love. Here is another library pocket. Inside another card and another simple tag with love stamped on it. And here also a stamped flower. And some more stamping. Here, as you can see, I could no longer add anything, or else I could not use it. So, this is a pocket I created with some flowers from Tsunami Rose. I fussy cut them. And here is some gauze, and inside I included a journaling paper from the kit, and also this folded envelopes like the ones Paula Lemon does. Here I stamped the corners, and here I stamped also a sentence. I don't know if you can see. Keep some room in your heart for the unimaginable. And here is one envelope I made, decorated with crochet and paper flowers. Inside, index card, that's the word. It's an index card written with a stamped flower. And on the back of it I have another journaling card with a hummingbird. And this is the last page. Here is exactly as the front. One created one pocket with the border punch, stamped this book belongs to, and inside another tag and another envelope from the kit with some journaling paper inside. And that's it. I hope you liked it, and if you did, please leave me a comment and subscribe, and thank you for watching. Bye!